Hello everybody, here I have a look at two elegant bokers, an old one of which I don't know the name, but it's very beautiful, and I will first start with this one, the CDC Schmelzer. And here I will really open it out of the box, because I can imagine that several of you don't know how Boker knives are often, especially the nicer ones, are often packaged. So you get them, the nicer ones at least, in this kind of box, which looks a bit like, you could say, a jewelry box, or you could say perhaps expensive Belgian chocolates. So it already makes it suitable as a nice gift, and it already, you could say, radiates a kind of pride of ownership. The very limited ones with Damascus blade bokers, those often have a wooden box or a metal box, but this box is often used. So I open it. So here, what do we see before I show you the knife? A little paper with actually a picture of the knife that says this knife is from their custom design collection. So actually every year they make a special version of one of their knives, or a few of their knives, just a handful. And in this case you see here Schmelzer in Trier. Well, Schmelzer, and that is here, you have the background here, well, in German, is actually a very old knife shop, already 270 years old, in the city of Trier, which is a lovely German city with Roman origins actually. And if you ever get there, which I can recommend because it's so charming, there is even a restaurant that makes true Roman dishes. And it's good for the credibility that indeed there were no dishes with potato on the menu. It was really Roman stuff. And okay, a little card here. Now let's have a look here at the knife. Notice already how beautiful the wood is here. It has a luxurious appearance, and I really think this is one of my most elegant, high quality gentleman knives, this one. So only 62 grams, very light. And this is actually beech wood, which is normally doesn't have this kind of structure, but I think they found a very old beech wood, which they stabilized and compressed, and that's how it gets this wonderful structure. Stainless bolsters, nicely polished. I will open it. Well, it's a two-hand opening knife, as is typical for a classic gentleman knife, with a polished blade as well. Look. Isn't this an absolute beauty? The blade itself is 3.5 inches long. The cutting edge is just a tiny bit less here. It doesn't have a real groin, but you can get it pretty close. It uses, so it is, what is interesting here, that it's such a nice mix of the traditional and the modern. It uses the N690 steel, which is made by Böhler in Austria, which is actually pretty similar in composition to VG10 steel, the very good Japanese steel. And indeed, it is a good, well-performing steel. That's also used often by the military Fox knives and a number of other good quality European producers. So that's what I like about this, modern design. A modern blade in a timeless design. That's really wonderful. So non-threatening at all, very gentle, very elegant. And so it's a backlock, and that is something that Boker historically knows very, very well how to do. It goes very smoothly, as you can see. The blade is nicely in the center here. It doesn't touch the bottom here, it doesn't touch the backspring, because there is a kind of a stop there. Well, it's properly done. So I really think it's wonderful. Now, it's no use for you to try and find it, because it's already sold out. Something like 140 or 100 were made, and they're already sold. There is, however, of this knife model, there is actually a Damascus version also, which is of course more expensive, but it looks just as wonderful, obviously, as this one. There is one thing which is disappointing. Well, you cannot imagine, well, how can this be disappointing? Well, actually, if you have the broker brochure of the second, in fact the second of last year, because they have two brochures per year, you could see the production picture of this knife, and then the blade here didn't have this big broker logo. It was simply clean with here in a small text it said broker Solingen, which I think was much nicer than here to have this very visible logo here. I think this detracts a bit for the classic elegance. And also here, I think here the, well, let's put it this way, the N690 from Boiler, I also think it didn't need to be that big. Notice here, it were 100 were made actually. It says it's the 94th knife out of 100, that the one that I have. So I really think this is absolutely wonderful. This is totally gentle companion knife, one of Boker's nicest ever in my opinion. So let's now have a look here at this older one. It's around 100 grams heavy. The other one was 62, so that's quite a difference. Still pretty carryable, very thin actually. Now I don't know the name of this one, and if any of the viewers has an old Boker catalog where the name is written, that would be splendid if you could post it in the feedback. So it is also a two-hand knife with the nail knee. The other one didn't need the nail knee because it's so smooth. So I think this is really a wonderful blade shape. Actually, there is still a model called the Titan, from, because it has a titanium handle, which is actually the same kind of handle, but in one piece of titanium and the same blade form. But how this actually was called, I don't know. So it has stainless bolsters and a wooden, I think, colored. It looks a bit like oak to me, I'm not certain. Colored wooden handle and a smoothly working backlock with a pretty thin blade actually. It's around 2 mm, so it's a very good slicer. The blade here is a bit an older German steel actually that Boker, I don't think they still use it in their modern knives. Well, actually it's not written on here, but because it's so similar to the Titan knife with exactly the same blade, and that blade has 4034 as a steel, which from what I read somewhere is a bit comparable to 420 HC that Buck uses. So it's better than the normal 420. It will hold an edge a bit better and it's still easy to sharpen, considering the lighter use that you would expect of such a bit of gentleman in nature. It's quite enough. No, so I bought this very cheap actually. I bought it around I think 25 euros or so. And I really think this is nice actually. It's a fun form. Still, well, it's probably designed from the 1990s, perhaps from the 1980s, but it still looks very good. And being a Boker, it's a very smooth operating backlock. It works very well. Here, notice by the way, there is a little tree. Because Boker actually means beech, it's a beech tree actually, that's what it means, that's the logo of the brand. So I put them side by side to show, well, this venerable German company, they know very well what they are doing actually. I really like many of their products. Here you have an older one, which is still very charming. Yeah, the blade is also around 3 inches, a bit longer perhaps, but still very very beautiful and good in the hand while it's so simple in form. And here the new one, so to show that really next to the high-end more tactical folders, which are relatively expensive, especially I think towards an American audience because of the conversion rate, they also know very well how to make elegant timeless knives with a very beautiful fit and finish. I actually think this one is as nicely made as my Mokis, which is saying something because that's an awesome brand as well. So I hope you found this an interesting review, and feel free to leave feedback.